This is not a test. This is not a test. Hey guys, good morning. It is 9:35 and the black tank on our camper's full. Last time that we emptied it out, it was a test. We were just testing it. This time it's not a test. We do, however, have the insurance policy of the toilet in the house still functioning, which won't be true for too long. So I'm timing myself this morning to see how quickly I can get this done. And we're also testing to see, hey, when the black tank's actually full of poo, can we actually pump it to the house with this macerator pump, which basically grinds poo and pumps it through a garden hose. We're pumping the waste from our trailer into the septic of our house. So I'm gonna run this over here. My filming might be a little sloppy because I'm trying to figure out how quickly I can get this done. So I'm not prioritizing making my filming beautiful. All right, you guys, you gotta move. I'm pulling the van through here to get my power. This pump is powered by the 12 volts in a car electrical plug-in, so we gotta get the car up there. I'm not bothering to get this thing crazy close. I'm just putting it close enough to get this extension cord to it. That's what we're doing this time. Gloves on. We're gonna get our hoses out. I forgot how bad this hose does in cold weather. It's super stiff this morning. This end goes into the septic clean out on the house. Put some bricks on there to make sure it doesn't move anywhere. Now we connect up this pump to the outlet on the camper. Then we connect up our freshwater flush hose and the hose that's pumping up the hill to the pump. Okay, those are done. You can turn this hose on now, Justice. All right, I'm connecting this extension cord to the power in the van. We're opening up our black tank and we're gonna cut this pump on. Hopefully this works. Let's go. And I'm just listening to the pump to make sure it doesn't have trouble with anything. New gloves, clean gloves, because this hose sprung a leak right here. Fortunately, I had some zip tape so I could throw it on there, but I caught it by the smell and it was terrible. We are actually moving poo today, guys. This hose's last run. We're gonna have a brand new 100-foot hose and we'll cut it to length. It was literally like drops that I could smell, but it was coming out. I was like, oh my gosh, it's so bad. So stinky. And Kurt, we're flushing the black tank, which is one of the last steps in this process. The pump's working beautifully. And we're about ready to empty that black tank for the last time. So that went great, and it drained everything in the tank. We've not been putting toilet paper in. Had a little issue, had the hose, there was a hole in the hose that leaked, so I put tape on it in the middle of it, so it like leaked out a very small volume, and then I flushed the whole area of the yard. Just we'll keep the kids out of that area of the yard till the sun's on it for a day or two.
What, should I just buy a new hose?
I think I've got one that'll work.
Okay.
I may need to buy a 3/4 hose. I need to look at the one I've got. One thing I want to check is this little black tank, gray tank sensor. I have a feeling this sensor isn't functioning, and I think it's probably an easy thing to go wrong. See, the black tank still says it has stuff in it. I think it's the sensors wrote bad on it.
But it did tell us when it was full.
Kind of. Yeah, I mean, it did.
It did. It says it's 3/4 full, and then it did say it's full when it was full.
Yeah. So if you think about a floating sensor, I guess they're floating after research in a tank, that has a bunch of sediment and solids in it. That there's a lot of potential there for that to get caught or get screwed up. I think we got 40 gallons worth out of it. It was a solid, how long, over a week?
It was almost 2 weeks.
Yeah, so I don't think that the tank is actually full. I think it's a sensor issue. So we'll just have to keep an eye on that. I may actually flush it again with fresh water, which I did. I flushed it again. Anyway, and then the other thing we should do is get some, get a product that helps dissolve that and break that down and put it, flush it down the toilet regularly.
Okay.
Like a septic product. From the use we got out of the tank, I'm almost certain that it's not still 3/4 full because I drained it and drained it and drained it. And the flow on that, just with the flow on the pump, it took about 10 minutes to drain the tank. To me, that says I'm actually draining the whole 40-gallon volume of the tank. So I'm not too concerned about it, but we'll figure it out. Anyway, the pump worked great though. Slammed through everything, cleaned it out, and so we're back on track.
All he wants to do is be over here with her.
Are you a cow man? Are you a cowboy?
He'll say mama cow, that's what he'll say. Mama. He say mama cow? Say hi. There you go. You guys are so funny.
I'm adding some storage in the RV because there's just not quite enough. So I'm retrofitting these boxes that were shelves in our bedroom in the house. So I guess you could say technically we've started demo, though it was not in the structure of the building, but just attached to the building. I had to shorten this by one unit, and then this is gonna go up above our bed if I can figure out how to hang it. Fortunately, I've got this guy to help me out because it's nice to have an extra hand to do your work. Are you gonna help Daddy? Okay. Got to cut around this light here. We'll use a coffee mug to approximate this curve. Hey, let's hang up this shelf. Come on inside. So just a little perspective. This is the foot of our bed. And the kitchen is right there. I already hung up this little box behind me and hung up one on that side for clothing. And this one's gonna go up here. It's kind of funny because these sliding doors have to still be able to slide, so I can't just hang it to the wall. So there's framing right here in this corner that I can screw up into the ceiling. I can't screw through here, I'll be into the doors. And then I can put a support underneath. So I'll show you how that's gonna look. Fortunately, this wood is extremely light. This whole thing just weighs a couple pounds. It's some cheap wood from China. And hopefully this will fit around the light just like it's supposed to. Uh-oh, what happened? It doesn't fit around the light. I thought I gave that an extra 1/4 inch. Oh, it fits. It just fits a little tight. You have to use a lot of caution when you're working in camper. If you use screws that are too long, you'll go straight through the whole thing to the exterior. Then you'll have a problem. The challenge, though, is that there's nothing anchoring up front because there's no framing in here. And so I need to keep support it so the front doesn't come down. And I think what I'm gonna do will be enough. And then we have a bunch of added space in this bedroom. Even though it's slightly more claustrophobic, there's still plenty of space. It's hours since that last shot I took, and I was out with all the kids. Bree was working on organizing here in the camper. And I love you. So I'm gonna show you just a few little things that I've done since I got back. We hung up these hooks, so the kids have hooks everywhere. We just gotta find places. The kids have hooks. Oop, you almost dropped that in your lap. Yummy lentils for supper. So guys, it's been another great day in the homestead. We've made some significant progress forward. Pretty much just getting things as they need to be in here, and we're almost there. Just a few more little steps, and we can turn our attention away from this camper, move in, and organize. All right, guys, thanks for joining us. We'll see you soon. Bye.